Good morning, you all. Welcome to EduScription. So, next experiment of the fluid mechanics lab is your Francis turbine, and the aim of the experiment to study the characteristics and find out its efficiency of a Francis turbine. And the aim of the experiment and also the basic apparatus are Francis turbine test rig, some weights and measuring device, that is your tachometer. Next, we move for the theory part. In the theory part, in a reaction turbine, a part of water energy is converted into kinetic energy at entrance, and the other part remains in the form of pressure energy. As water flows through the runner, this pressure energy is converted into kinetic energy, thus the pressure is high at the inlet part and gradually decrease at the outlet. So, briefly, both pressure energy and kinetic energy converted into mechanical energy. The main part of the Francis turbine are scroll casing, guide mechanism, and also runner and draft tube. The scroll casing is also known as spiral casing. It provides an even distribution of water around the circumference of the turbine runner, maintaining a constant velocity. The steering consists of an upper and lower ring held together by a series of fixed vanes. The van regulates the quantity of water supplied to the runner. The vanes on the runner are also so sharp that water enters to the runner radially at the outer periphery and leave it axially at the inner periphery. The change in direction of the flow of water produces a circumferential force on the runner, which make the runner to rotate. So, about the operations, Francis turbine consists of a scroll casing and outer pedestal, rotor assembly with runner shaft and brake drum. All are mounted in a strong cast iron base plate. A straight conical draft tube, which is provided for the purpose of regaining pressure energy from the exit part, and also facilitating easy accessibility of the turbine due to its location at higher level than trailers. Another part is the raw brake dynamometer for finding out the brake power, which is needed for our efficiency. Okay, this is the brake drum and this is the rope. And here we give the dead weight, and the opposite part is the spring balance. That's why we finally find out the torque. And for brake power, that's formula is 2 pi nt. Okay, for calculation of the torque, this is necessary. Now we start the power supply here. Then all are in position. Slowly we open the valves, opening and closing valve. This is your motor part. When the motor is start, automatically it pressurizes and goes towards the venturimeter, and already we know the part of the venturimeter. It maintains a constant rate of flow of the fluid particle. So this is in high pressure, so it maintains a constant rate of flow, and that pressure is goes, that water goes towards this casing. Okay, inside it another vanes and scroll vanes and guide vanes are there. That's why that water will goes through this and rotate the shaft. That's why that shaft is connected with this brake and drum arrangement. This person is used for pulling the brake drum. This is used for pulling the brake drum. Now, in this machine, we maintain a constant RPM 1000. When we put the weight here, at that time it maintain a constant 1000 RPM. Before that, we set both the weight is zero and here also coincide with zero. Open the P1 and P2. P1 is the inlet pressure and P2 is the throat pressure. Simultaneously, we open the turbine head. Actually, turbine head is your HS plus HD, suction plus delivery. This turbine head is for both addition of HS plus HD. Here, you just mark here. This indicates inlet, this is throat, and this is turbine head. And this is basically if any air bubbles inside the draft tube, then it indicates the. So, no air bubble inside the draft tube. So, it is maintained as zero. We give the weight here and simultaneously we increase the speed. That's why it maintain a constant RPM. So 1000 RPM means it is just 1015 and 985 within this. If it is maintained, constant, that is your 15 plus or minus. So now it is 1000 RPM nearly. So here the pressure reading. Here now we give here
6 kg weight
and simultaneously the W2 is your 0.045. Here 0.045. Simultaneously the P1 P2 is your, here P1 is your 2.15 and P2 is your 0.045. 0.045. Simultaneously, the turbine head is your 0.25. This is your 0.25. Next, we move for the calculation part. Initially, we take inlet pressure is your 2.25 kg per centimeter square, throat pressure 1, and turbine head is your 0.35. For basic calculation of the input power, that is your WQH. So here discharge is your K into root over. This K is the Venturi constant and that's value is 0.013. Similarly, this is P1, P2 and when we convert it into head, that is your, we multiply 10. So finally, the discharge is your 0.045 meter cube per second. Simultaneously, when we put this value in input power, that is your 9.81 W, Q and this is your turbine head. So finally we find out this value is your 1.103 kilowatt. Next part is the brake power. In brake power the basic formula is your 2 pi NT by 60,000. And here we from your observation we find out this is the dead weight 6 kg, rope 1 kg, that is 7 kg and the opposite spring balance reading is your 0.45. So finally, when we put this value 2 pi, this is the speed RPM, constant RPM for 5 observation, that is your 1000, okay, and this is the RE, value of RE, which is the effective radius, that is your 0.115, and finally we got 0.821, this is your brake power, and the efficiency is your brake power by input power into 100. So this is your brake power, input power, and finally we got 70.15%. Next, we move for the tabulation part. In the tabulation part, we are taking 4 observations, and these are the P1 and P2, inlet pressure and throat pressure, and similar way that this is the discharge, and we are giving, these are the weights, brake weight, and simultaneously this is the spring balance reading, finally input, output, and the efficiency. And in the conclusion part, we studied the different parts and function of the Francis turbine, and find out its efficiency, that is 58.87. Thank you.